Welcome to the another video on the hypothesis in the decision making theory. Today we have Friedman-Savage hypothesis. In the previous classes we have already learned Bernoulli's hypothesis and St. Petersburg paradox and NM utility hypothesis. Today this is the third hypothesis in the decision making theory. Let's look and go into the video. And people, according to the hypothesis, according to the Friedman-Savage hypothesis, the people will make bet, or people are ready to engage in gambling even under very unfavorable situations, even under very unfavorable odds, or even if the game is highly unfavorable, people may be ready to take the risk. They are not in fact the irrational individual, they are rational individuals itself, but people may be ready, or some people are ready to take the risk even under very unfavorable situations, or very they are ready to play the unfavorable game even. This is in fact different from Bernoulli's hypothesis. As per the Bernoulli's hypothesis, people will avoid bet. People will avoid playing the game, playing the fair game even. They may not be ready to play even favorable game as they face diminishing marginal utility of money. But this is not the case always, according to Friedman and Savage, Friedman and L.J. Savage, and they have come up with their own hypothesis. It is popularly called Friedman-Savage hypothesis. And let's look into the hypothesis. According to Milton Friedman and L.J. Savage, same individual may engage in gambling on one hand and buy insurance on the other. And who will buy the insurance? The people who buy the insurance will be risk-averse individuals. They face a diminishing marginal utility of money, so they want to have a safer option. They don't want to take the risk in normal cases. They are not ready to play the game even though it is fair, but himself may be ready to play the game in certain other situations. So this hypothesis is talking about that kind of situations. The people are ready to engage in gambling or risky economic activities. So the hypothesis states that there could be risk averse behavior and there could be risk seeking behavior from the part of a same individual. So the same individual may become risk averse, he may become risk seeker, seeker, but this will not happen at a single time. This could happen in different time at different stages of income. So let's go to the details of that. So according to the Friedman-Savage hypothesis, the level of income could be categorized into three. One is lower stage of income, second one intermediate stage of income or middle stage of income, and third one higher level of income or higher stage of income. And the speciality of lower stage of income and higher stage of income are equal. Both stages, the individual faces diminishing marginal utility of money up to a certain level. Up to a certain level of income, the individual faces diminishing marginal utility of money. And after a certain period of time, after a certain level of income, individual's income crosses a higher boundary, then he faces diminishing marginal utility of money. And when he faces diminishing marginal utility of money, that individual is said to be risk-averse individual. He is not ready to play the game. He is not ready to play even a fair game. He may not be ready to play the game, which is in fact favorable game, due to the loss of utility will be greater than the gain of utility in this case. So he is not ready to play a fair game. surely. But the intermediate stage of income is the middle stage of income in which the individuals are ready to play the game as they face increasing marginal utility of money. So they face increasing marginal utility of money as they want to improve their socio-economic status. They want to take their socio-economic status with that of the persons with higher stage of income. They want to increase their income. They want to take their socio-economic status to that of a higher income people. So they are risk seekers. As they face increasing marginal utility of money, they may be ready to play the game even the game is highly unfavorable. So they will take the bet. They will engage in gambling. They may purchase the lottery ticket. They will not buy any insurance as they don't want to insure their risk. They are ready to play the game. So this is the speciality of the middle stage of income, middle income people. And when come to the third stage or higher stage of income, it is same as that of the lower stage of income. People face diminishing marginal utility of money. They are already in a higher status. They don't want to take the risk anymore. They are risk averse. They are not ready to play the game even it is a fair game. And this is clear from the diagram that I have given on the screen. You can see that along the horizontal axis, money income is measured, and along the vertical axis, marginal utility of money is measured. Unlike the risk averse, unlike the Bernoulli's hypothesis, in which the people faces diminishing marginal utility of money, here the same individual faces different phases of income. Different phases of income and different changes in marginal utility of money. So here you can see three stages of income. I1 is the first stage, that is the lower stage of income, where the individual faces diminishing marginal utility of money. As you can see, MU or marginal utility of money diminishes from R to R1. It is declining as income is increasing, and because of this feature, individual is a risk averse people, and as loss of utility will be greater than the gain of utility, he is not ready to play the game. And in the intermediate level of income, where his income is in between OI1 and OI2, I1 and I2 is the middle income stage, where the individual faces increasing marginal utility of money, and marginal utility is increasing from R1 to R2. It is increasing as income is increasing. They want to improve their socio-economic status, and they want to take their socio-economic status to higher level, or that of the higher income people. And this will happen up to I2, where marginal utility reaches the peak of R2. And the third stage of income is higher income stage, where the individual again faces diminishing marginal utility of money. Marginal utility diminishes from R2 to R3. This is happening as income is increasing from I2 to I3. So here also, the individual is risk averse, and he or she is not ready to play even if the game is fair. So this is the speciality of the lower income people and higher income people. And there are some people, there is a situation for the people who are facing increasing marginal utility of money when their income is in between the middle income stage, and then they are ready to play the game. So the same individual may go through these three different phases of income, and he may be risk averse in some situation, he may be risk seeker in some other situation. so to speak, specifically lower income people will be unwilling to take the risk as his marginal utility of money is diminishing and he is not ready to play even the game is fair. Middle income people are willing to take the risk as they want to improve their socioeconomic status further and they want to take their socioeconomic status to that of the high income people, and they are facing increasing marginal utility of money, so the gain of their utility will be greater than loss of utility when playing a fair game, and even an unfair game they are ready to play the game. And the third stage is higher income people. Higher income people are unwilling to take the risk as they are already achieved their economic status, they have reached the peak of income, and they are unwilling to take the risk as they are also facing diminishing marginal utility of money. So this is Friedman-Savage hypothesis. Thank you.